Hello friends, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I feel pleasure to share a very important as well as interesting topic, modular arithmetic from number theory to you, which is a very basic concept for preparing maths Olympiad or other competitive examinations. So modular arithmetic is nothing but arithmetic of remainders. Modular arithmetic is a very familiar use in 12-hour clock, in which the day is divided into two 12-hour periods. If the time is 8 hours now, then after 8 hours, it will be 16. But do we say it is 16? Simple addition would result 8 plus 8, 16. But 16 hours reads as 4 on the clock face, because clocks wrap around every 12 hours and the hour number starts over at 0 when it reaches 12. So 16 hours is equivalent to 4 hours when we talk about 12 hours clock. We say 16 is congruent to 4 modulo 12, written as 16, and this is the symbol of congruency, that is same as equivalency, 4 mod 12. We read as 16 is congruent to 4 modulo 12. So in the same way, we can say 16 is congruent to 4 modulo 12. 21 is congruent to 9 modulo 12. 12 is congruent to 0 modulo 12. So what is this congruence? Let us learn more. So today's our video is about modular congruences. Congruence is nothing but more than a statement about divisibility, first introduced by the physicist Carl Friedrich Gauss. It talks about let n be a positive integer. Two integers a and b are congruent modulo n if they each have the same remainder on division by n. We write a is congruent to b modulo n. This is the mathematical symbol. Such a statement is called a congruence. Let's analyze it again. If a and b are integers, maybe positive, maybe negative, but n is a positive integer, then a is congruent to b modulo n if and only if n divides a minus b. So this is the symbol, a is congruent to b mod n if and only if n divides a minus b, or the difference of a and b is k times of n multiple of n, or a is equal to b plus k times of n. Some examples. 15 is congruent to 3 modulo 4. That means when 15 is divided by 4, we get the remainder 3. Similarly, 31, if we divide by 4, we get again the remainder 3. 4 7s are 28, remainder is 3. So 15 and 13 are congruent to 3 modulo 4. 15 and 13 are congruent to modulo 4. Let us take another example. 19 is congruent to 5 modulo 7. 12 is congruent to 5 modulo 7. That means 19 and 12 when they are divided by 7, each gives the remainder 5. So 19 and 12 are congruent modulo 7. Another example, 9 is congruent to 2 modulo 7, 2 is congruent to negative 5 modulo 7, that means if I'll divide 2 with 7, then I'll get 2, 7, 1 times 7, so remainder will be negative 5. So 9 and 2 are congruent to negative 5 modulo 7. Let's solve some questions for better understanding which of the following congruences are true. First question is, 11 is congruent to 26 modulo 5. Whether it's true or false. This is very simple, as we got the definition that n should divide a minus b. Here for this first question, a is 11, b is 26, and n is your 5. We have to see whether a minus b is divisible by n or not. So 11 minus 25, 26 is equal to negative 15. Is it divisible by 5? Yes. So this is true. Next question. 9 is congruent to negative 9 modulo 5. So 9 minus 9, this will be 18. Is it divisible by 5? No. So this is false. Next, 28 is congruent to 0 modulo 7. Yes, 28 minus 0 is divisible by 7, so it is true. Next question. Negative 4 is congruent to negative 18 modulo 7. So negative 4 minus minus 18. So this will be plus 18, that will be 14. Is it divisible by 7? Yes, so it is true. Next is, negative 8 is congruent to 5 modulo 13. So minus 8 minus 5 is minus 13. Yes, this is divisible by 13, so this is true. Next is, f 38 is congruent to 0 modulo 13. So 38 minus 0 is 38. So 38 is not divisible by 13. So this is false. I hope you have understood. Now you can solve some more questions yourself. Which of the following congruences are true or false? 63 is congruent to 14 modulo 7. So you can check 63 minus 14. 9, 4, yes, it is true. Next is, 39 is congruent to, so you'll test minus 39, again minus 39 is equal to negative 78. It is not divisible by 7, so this is false. Next coming to C, 63. It's congruent to 14 modulo 12, so it will be 63 minus 14. It is again false. Next is your negative 8, 16, so it is true. Next is, this is also true. So this is also true. So thank you for watching, and in the next session we'll go for some more. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to watch more such videos. This was only the introduction of the number three. We'll proceed and we'll learn more and more. Thank you. Please keep on watching, because next video will be least residual system modulo M, so that we can learn more. Thank you for watching.